Say the words jet fighter and immediately people get excited. Today we're looking at the future of jet projects, either those coming down the line or those ideas which plummeted to Earth after much promise. If you're expecting to see planes such as the F-22 Raptor, F-35, SU-27, or SU-35, we haven't got them on our rundown. Why? Because you can find out about them on another video we made. For now, let's focus on 10 interesting future projects. Number 1. The Mikoyan MiG-41. Russian airspace is vast, with great distances being traveled by its military planes. With tensions around the world ratcheting up, defense experts are planning what the next phase of air defense in the country will be. Currently, the MiG-31 Foxhound is there to intercept any aggressive visitors. They haven't been made since 1994, but reports say they're good for at least another decade. In the meantime, what's being thought about? There are a few projects, but one that's gotten attention is the proposed MiG-41, which is being made by the company Mikoyan. Because it's a sixth-generation jet, the emphasis is on futuristic design and capabilities the Air Force hasn't seen before. It's been suggested the MiG-41 could reach speeds in excess of Mach 4, or 3,069 miles per hour, and fly so high it's within spitting distance of space. It might even be unmanned, though this has to be confirmed. Ultimately, these ambitious planes cost money, and doubts have been cast on whether the plane can actually get off the ground. Latest info is that designs and research will be completed by the end of 2019, so watch this space. Number 2. Silbervogel. Translating as Silver Bird, this design for a devastating weapon was a success story not just in the way its German team hoped. In the late 1930s, aerospace engineer Eugene Sanger and his wife and colleague Irene Brett submitted the plans for Silbervogel to the Third Reich. The Nazis wanted to target areas around the Atlantic Ocean, specifically New York, in a program imaginatively titled America Bomber. What was interesting about this project was the trajectory of the jet. It wouldn't just head up into the sky. Sanger and Brett pictured it going into suborbit. Silbervogel would have a sleek silver body packing 90 tons of fuel and be launched along a 2-mile, 3.2-kilometer track with V-2 rockets. 90 miles, 145 kilometers into the air, it would hit a staggering Mach 30, 23,018 miles per hour, before plunging back down to the Earth in the direction of the Big Apple. However, due to its design, which promoted lift, it would have gradually descended in a way that's been compared to a stone skimming on the surface of some water. Hitler never managed to take advantage of the Silbervogel because funding was needed for other things like fighting the Soviet Union. Russia nearly scored the plane, but eventually it wound up in America of all places. The principles behind the Silver Bird manifested themselves in the NASA space shuttle, a cosmic end to what could have been a horrifying chapter in wartime history. Number 3. Northrop Grumman RQ-180. It was a top-secret project for the US Air Force, and finding out details on Northrop Grumman's RQ-180 naturally proved a tough challenge for aviation buffs. Finally introduced to the air in 2015 and replacing the Lockheed SR-71, which was stood down in 1998, the result is seen as a key asset in America's military stealth. The RQ-180 has an aerodynamic design that's referred to as cranked kite. The wingspan is 130 feet, 40 meters, and the plane has pointed edges that have been compared to toothpicks. Much speculation occurred over what the Air Force were working on for the next generation of air defense. Footage taken from sky cameras, for example, showed a hangar that could hold a plane of a certain size. That enabled snoopers to make some educated guesses before the RQ-180 was officially unveiled. Intended for use in ISR, or intelligence surveillance and reconnaissance, it's also a UAS, as in unmanned aerial system. Throw in the CIA as joint controller of the project and you have something straight out of a spy novel. Number 4. The FMA IAE-37. In 1950s Argentina, designer Riomar Horton worked on a jet fighter design that was interesting and in some ways unique. Horton, together with his brother Walter, hailed from Germany. They were known for being aircraft designers in spite of the fact they weren't officially trained to do so. This unconventional approach led to the development of the IAE-37 jet fighter. While it went beyond the drawing board, it didn't make it into the air as a propeller plane. Even so, the design is worth looking at, as a glimpse at a future that never arrived. It had a flying wing design, meaning there was no fuselage and everything pretty much happened in the wings. Horton's team put together some scale models and a prototype was built in the form of a wooden glider. To pilot the glider, you had to lie down and look through the nose, though that was revised into something more like you'd find in a regular plane. Why did it fail? For starters, there was a complex political background of Argentina where leaders rose and fell, making consistency in military programs difficult to maintain. Eventually, knowledge gained from the work on the IAE-37 was used to produce two craft, though nothing got the green light and everything wrapped up by the end of this turbulent decade. Number 5. New Generation Fighter. What better name to call a futuristic military jet plane than New Generation Fighter? This sixth generation plane was reported on in 2018 at the Euro Naval Exhibition, and it represents a joining of forces between France, Germany, and Spain. It's manufactured by Airbus and Dassault Aviation, and is set to replace existing air defense craft in around 15 years' time. The New Generation Fighter, or NGF for short, has a delta wing design. A delta wing is essentially where the jet resembles a giant triangle. It also has a V-tail, where the tail takes on a V-shaped configuration rather than the more usual fins. The NGF has a lack of vertical surfaces, so it's trickier to detect by radar, which reflects laterally off of anything vertical. This year, a full-scale model made its debut at the Paris Air Show, where everyone could see this exciting project for themselves. Number 6. VFW VAC 191B. Part of a bigger German Air Force program, the VFW VAC 191B ended its days as a demonstrator rather than an official jet fighter. But while it started off as a state-of-the-art defense plane and wound up a learning tool for other projects, it still had one hell of a ride. It could have been a nuclear strike fighter with devastating firepower in the event of a national or global emergency. Designed and manufactured by VFW, or Vereinigte Flugtechnik-Werke, hope they don't mind if we just say VFW, it had a vertical takeoff and landing system and could attain speeds of up to Mach 1.4, 1,074 miles per hour. There's the VFW and then there's the VAK, which stands for Vertical Takeoff Reconnaissance and Strike Aircraft. The plane was compared to the Harrier in Britain, though there are some key differences, such as the ability to fly supersonic for extended periods. While this design had a shot at glory in the aircraft stakes, it's probably best we have as few nuclear jets as possible if we want to survive into the next centuries. Number 7. Mitsubishi F-3. Japan is known for technological innovation, and its military are no different. With a major competitor in China threatening to set them back, they've been developing their very first home-based stealth fighter. The official name is the Mitsubishi F-3, but it's known over there as Shinshin, or One's Mind. Another meaning for it is Mount Fuji, which sums up this big project quite nicely. Japan did make an attempt to buy F-22 Raptors from the Americans, but their offer was turned down. This is reported as another factor behind the decision to take fighter production in-house. The plane began as an ATDX, Advanced Technology Demonstrator. The fifth generation jet is scheduled to be out there in the next decade and is equipped with 3D thrust vectoring and an active electronically scanned array radar system, or AESA. If that doesn't sound futuristic enough, then how about this? Shinshin is able to repair its own flight control systems in midair. When this hits the sky, it sounds like it's going to be pretty formidable. Number 8. McDonnell Douglas A-12 Avenger II. While it's easy to get the impression that America is king when it comes to military capacity, they do make bad calls. The A-12 Avenger II, manufactured by McDonnell Douglas and General Dynamics, was an especially bad call. Not so much in terms of the jet itself, but how the project was handled. The Avenger was seen as the future of American airspace defense. However, it got canceled in 1991 by former Defense Secretary Dick Cheney. This was down to a combination of factors, such as the lengthy time it took to put the plane together, plus controversial management, not to mention the thawing of relations between America and the Soviet Union. In fact, it wasn't until 2014 that the matter of the Avengers' cancellation was resolved following a litigation case. Talk about a hot potato. The jet is seen as a colossal missed opportunity for a U.S. stealth bomber. Developed as a long-range aircraft, it could also be launched from an aircraft carrier. It just goes to show how complicated these planes are, not only to make, but to turn into a reality in the first place. Number 9. BAE Systems Tempest. This really is the jet plane of the future. Projected to take to the skies in 2035, the Tempest is a joint project between various entities under the name of Team Tempest. The British contributors are BAE Systems, with the jet referred to as BAE Systems Tempest, Rolls-Royce, and the Ministry of Defense. The other players are Italian company Leonardo S.p.A. and European manufacturer MBDA. Announced at the Farnborough Air Show last year, Tempest looks like it could take military flights into the space age. The cockpit is reported as minimalist, with most functions performed virtually via the pilot's helmet. There is, of course, still a stick to pilot the plane with. Everything else is controlled with technology. As these things don't come cheap, there's been a 2 billion euro investment, which takes the project up to 2025. A partnership with Sweden was also set up this year to help take things to the next level. Number 10, Northrop Grumman X-47B. We've mentioned demonstrators before on this rundown, as in flyers that won't make it out of the testing center. Their role is to provide data for other projects, but some go on to have a life of their own. One of those is the Northrop Grumman X-47B. It was originally intended to be stood down in 2015 and donated to a museum. However, the United States Navy have kept them in service. The X-47B is a UCAV, or Unmanned Combat Aerial Vehicle. Shaped like a triangle, it dispensed with a tail, having what's called a blended wing body design. The shape reduces detection by radar. It's able to operate semi-autonomously and can refuel in midair. All in all, the project was a positive one. An initial plan of 50 tests over a 3-year period was abandoned when the X-47B showed good results in just 16 tests. No wonder they weren't consigned to the scrap heap. And who knows, they may form part of the future in terms of other groundbreaking jet projects. Jet projects are always in development. It's hard to keep up, but hopefully we've given you a bird's eye view of the situation. If you liked the video, then click the subscribe button and turn on notifications, and you'll be the first to know when we release a new video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.